Well, while the quiz portion has ended as we continue our month-long series of Weather 101, we still have answers to some of the most often asked questions and about some of weather's most amazing facts. Today, the true difference between a tornado and what is known as a microburst. Now, while tornadoes and microbursts can both sound like freight trains and have winds over 100 miles an hour, there are some pretty big differences also. Temperatures usually form on the backside of an extremely strong thunderstorm and contain spiraling winds. Microbursts are surges of wind that come straight directly out of the thunderstorm and can be produced by rain-cooled air rushing to the ground or a storm tapping into some upper-level winds. The damage can be so similar that sometimes the National Weather Service has to take a look at the damage to determine which one it was. When trees are twisted or debris has fallen in random patterns, that swirling wind means a tornado. When the damage all falls in all the same direction, it's a microburst. So since we only see one or two tornadoes a year in the state of New Hampshire, most oftentimes it is a microburst when investigated. One exception was the 50-mile track tornado back in July of 2008 here in New Hampshire, where the tornado formed where the microburst usually does in the storm, inside the heavy rain of the thunderstorm that created it, which is why no one saw that tornado for 90 minutes that it was on the ground. Now, Monday in Weather 101, we're going to take a closer look at a phenomenon known as heat lightning. What is it and what it means? That's Weather 101 right here at this time on Monday morning on Daybreak.
Yeah, and people wonder what these investigators from the National Weather Service look at, and that's exactly what it is.
Yeah, they're looking for the twisting of the trees for a possible tornado or the everything falling in all the same direction being a microburst.
Both can be very damaging regardless.